blessed when you're an orange, and also blessed. And I feel especially blessed in that, that I have a backdrop that is perhaps not typical. I did actually want to start with the poems that appear in Smartish Pace. I wasn't going to read Condolence Mode, but I think I will now. Thank you so much. And I have timed myself. I actually will delete one because I've timed myself to be slightly under 20 minutes because I don't want to take any more time from Greg. I must admit that my own death is beginning to interest me. That I don't think I have a soul, that even if I lack this pale bird, I don't want to be buried or burned. I want to be sewn in a sack and given to the ocean. That I want bagpipes to dirge my body down, my body in a black dress, my body in a black dress with sequins. That I want some flimsy shimmer of me fitted with black glittering wings to hover above the boat, the huge, beautiful, black sheeted boat, and listen to the skirl till the last drop stops my ears. And I'm glad that Condolence Note strikes anyone as being humble and honest, which I think it actually is, because that one is so... I tried to capture my own self-dramatizingness I must admit, Condolence Note. Think of me as an elephant, hippo, draft mare, derrick, head to the ground, eyes fetlock level, feel the dull weight of my shoulder, or rather my withers, against your shoulder, the methodical plod of my jaws, the mild bluster of my breath where it joins your breath as we stand grazing on the grave's wild greens. Feel how big I am, how soft. Feel my dumb warmth heaved heavy and leathern against your grieving. And the next one I want to read is the only one that requires some backstory. It was actually written during one of those rare moments when I really was interested, if not in my own death, in my own misdiagnosed near death. It's called McCrory's Big Blue Sign, and it has two backstories, and one is metric. It's McCrory's, as some of you may remember, if you're from Baltimore, was a chain of 5 and 10 cent stores, and so it's in 10-line stanzas of 5 feet each. And there are four of them, that's sort of almost like a dollar, I guess. But I'd had to have, this is useful for the poem, I'd had to have MRIs and angiograms and sonograms and all sorts of stuff, which yielded astonishing misdiagnoses like, silly us, you don't have a completely blocked carotid artery, you have an enormous hole in your carotid artery, you know, the future brain. But what's really interesting is the machines. You know, they're lying beside you or on top of you, and they're making these huge, blustering, snoring noises. They're monsters, but the monsters are you. They're your doppelganger because it's your body that's making most of those noises. So I thought that was interesting. Part one, like a hole in the head, what you don't need. A hole in the hose that squirts the brain awake, jerks the reins, makes the creature walk. Black and white like that 40s Dorian Gray. The ultrasound picture now pulses technicolor, the movie's final shot. Curtain yanked aside. My heart's Doppler choo-choo so huge it seems my body must burst. The body works miracles, the tech praises were praised. Knock on wood, the Irish may, knuckles to jokester skull. Part two, jokester body. The body's sense of humor is proved as God's. Guileful, willful, worse than the bluest movie. No wit, much schmutz, depends on stinks and belches. Many a true word is spoken in earnest, but Dandy Wild died splattering the ceiling with his guts, a belly laugh on the mannered world. As for mine, God damn the bitch, I loved her like a dog, a horse, I stroked and stoked her like a lightsome lover, and now she shows her ass to Dr. Death with his buzz and his sleazy grin. Part 3, 5 and 10. McCrory's had a notions counter. Like Huschel's or Huxley's, like it wasn't just a 5 and a 10. Notions were little pins, barrettes, elastic garters, things that seemed designed and set out on the section counter just to be stolen by kids. Obscene things, too, or so they looked. Finger stalls and long, skin-colored balloons, what were they? Condoms? I still wonder. Things that remind us things slide in and out, notions. The bodies are dirty jokes. Part 4, Doppelganger. The machine that roars beside me, who? I knew someone who snored like the B&O and woke everyone asleep on 26th Street, that blue-black opening where tunnels joined. Yet I loved my great-grandmother and hated myself for holding a smothering pillow ready. Some people say I snore. I call them liars who go to sleep dead drunk and wake up bitching. Only family's allowed to laugh at her, my double, my familiar. How I'll miss her.